गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी डिस्कस द एसएसटी चैप्टर लाइफ लाइन ऑफ नेशनल इकॉनमी. सो लाइफ लाइन ऑफ नेशनल इकॉनमी. टुडे इंडिया इज़ वेल लिंक्ड विद द रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड डिस्पाइट ऑफ इट्स वास्ट साइज डिवर्सिटी एंड लिंग्विस्टिक एंड सोशो कल्चरल प्लुरिटी. रेलवे एयरवेज वाटरवेज न्यूज़पेपर रेडियो टेलीविजन सिनेमा एंड इंटरनेट एक्सेट्रा हैव बीन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट to its social economic progress in many ways. The trades from local to international levels have added to the vitality of its economy. It has enriched our life and added substantially to growing amenities and facilities for the comforts of life. So that was the different diversity, linguistic, socio-cultural plurality and railway, airline, waterways, newspapers, radio, television, cinema, internet. That was all this contribute to the socio-economic progress. Transport in different ways. Roadways, railways, pipelines, waterways. Next one is airways. So that was the roadways lines. India has one of the biggest road network in the world, aggregate to about 2.3 million kilometer at present. The growing importance of roadway is because of low construction cost. It is economically, it provides door-to-door service. It is used as feeder to the other mode of transport. In India, roads are classified following six classes: Golden Quadrilateral Superhighways, National Highways, State Highways, District Roads, Other Roads and Border Roads. Golden Quadrilateral Superway Highways. It links Delhi, Calcutta, Chennai, Mumbai. The North-South and East-West corridor are part of this project. Objectives to reduce time, distance between mega cities of India. Projects implemented by National Highways Authority of India. That was the example of this roadways. National Highway. This links extreme part of the country. They are led by the Central Public Works Department. NH1 is a Sher Shah Suri Marg between Delhi and Amritsar. Here it is the example of the National Highways. State Highway. These link the state capital with the different district headquarters. They are maintained by the Public Worker Department. District Roads. Their roads connect the district headquarters with the other place of the district. Other and Border Roads. Rural roads, which link rural areas and village with towns, are classified under this category. Border Roads. Border Roads Organization of India undertakes construction and maintain roads in bordering area of India. Railways. It is the principal mode of transport in India. It binds the economic life of the country as well as accelerates the development of the industry and agriculture. Indian Railway has a network of 7031 stations spread over a route length of 63221 kilometer. Today, railway has become more important in our national economy than all other means taken together. That was the example of railway. Pipelines. Pipeline transportation system is a new arrival on the transportation map of India. These are used for transporting crude oil, petroleum products and natural gases. That was a pipeline system. Next one is waterways. India is one of the seafaring countries and the cheapest means of transport. It is most suitable to carrying heavy bulky materials. It is a fuel efficient. It is a most environmental friendly. India has inland navigation of 14500 km in length, out of only 37,000 km are navigable by the mechanist. Our national waterways are the Ganga River between Allahabad and Haldia, 1620 kilometers, National Highway number 1. The Brahmaputra River between Sindhia and Dhupri, 1891 kilometer, NHW2. The West Coastal Cell in Kerala, NW3. So next one is airways. It is the faster means of transport. It is the most comfortable. It is most prestigious, it's covered difficult trains, terriers, it is not within the reach of common man. It is a very fast technological way of communication. So communication for the Latin communis means to share. It is the activity of conveying information through the exchange of thoughts, message or information, as by speech, visuals, signals, writing or behavior. Mass communication is the academic study of how individuals and entities relay information through mass media to large segments of the population at the same time. It is usually understood to relate to newspaper and magazine publishing, radio, television and film, as they are used both of disseminating news and for advising. International trade is the exchange of capital, goods and services across international border or territories. In most countries, such trade represents a significant share of gross domestic product, that was the GDP. While international trade has been present throughout much of history, like sea, silk routes, Amber roads, its economic, social and political importance has been on the rise of the recent countries. So